Good morning everyone, this is Satish, working as a assistant professor in St. Martin's Engineering College. Today I am going to discuss about what is accounting and what is accounting cycle that we are discussing in this class. So here, the first we go for the first thing, what is accounting here? See here, what is accounting means, according to the American Institute of Certified Public Accountant, what is accounting means here, accounting is the art of recording. It is the art of recording, classifying and summarizing in a significant manner and in terms of money transactions and events which are in part at least financial character and interpreting the results thereof. So that means here, what is accounting means, simply it is the art of recording here. That means whatever the transactions are there, what are the business transactions are there, or what are the things that we had measured in terms of money, that the transactions we had entered in a systematic manner, that is called as art of entering of all the records in the books here. So that means it is an art of recording of all the transactions in the books of account here. So that is the first thing here. And when we go for the after recording, whatever the transactions that we had entered here, whatever the transactions that we had entered, that we had recorded in the books, that we had to classify into the different categories here. So simply, whatever the economic or business related transaction that we had to enter and the first thing here, and after entering or after recording of all the business transactions, we are classifying after some period of time based on the account here. So whatever the transaction is related to the different area, so based on that we are classifying, we are dividing of all these transactions into the separate account, that is called as classifying. So after classifying, again in a particular period of time we are summarizing here. So that means in each and every account we are maintaining separate account here, each and every transactions we are opening a separate account, and based on the values, based on the results of the particular account, again we are clubbing in an account or in a statement, that is called as trial balance. For the purpose of summarizing, we are using the trial balance here. So that means all the balances what we are classifying here, at end results of these classifying accounts details, we are summarizing a particular place. That place or that statement is called as trial balance here. So simply, first we are recording here, after that it will be divided into the different categories based on the account of the nature, and again we are summarizing of all the accounting details in a particular statement, and based on that whatever the things we are getting, that means after summarizing of this account, we are finding the results of the particular account, particular business here. So simply, after summarizing and based on the summarizing of the data, we are finding the end results here. That means the company, either it is getting a profit or loss, or what is the financial position of the company, that we have to find out here. And that we have to interpret it. That means that the results we have to interpret here, and who required the particular results, that we have told to the required parties here. So simply, accounting is what it is, the art of recording, classifying and summarizing, and based on that we are finding the end results of that particular account, either we are getting a profit or loss, or what is the financial position of the company, that we are finding here, and based on that whatever the results we are getting here, that we have to told or communicate to the required parties here, that is called as accounting. And when we go for the next definition of the accounting here, so as for the ACPA, that means American Institute of Certified Public Accountant, they have given another definition here. So what it means, accounting is the collection, measurement and recording, classification and the communication of economic data related to a particular enterprise for the purpose of reporting the decision making and control here. So that means same thing here. So we are collecting of all information, and it will be measured in terms of money that we have entered here, that we have recorded in the books of account, and based on that we are classifying to the different categories, and based on that whatever the results we are getting here, that we have to communicate to the required parties here. So what is the use of this results means, we are taking up the decision for the future period of time here, and how we are controlling of all the process, that must be taking the decision by using of the financial statements here. So these are the two definitions is given by the ACPA. And when we go for the next, the another definition is given by American Institute, American Accounting Association here. So AAA. So in 1966, then the American Accounting Association is defined. What is accounting means? Accounting is the process of identifying, that means we are identifying the economic transactions or business transactions, what we are to measure in terms of money. Whatever the things we are measured in terms of money, that transactions we have to identify here. And we are measuring of the things, and based on that we are communicating the economic information to the required parties here. It will be gives to the judgment or decision making for the future period of time for that particular business or enterprise, that is called as accounting here. So it is given by the American Accounting Association. So after that, then we go for the next one. So functions of accounting here. What are the functions and the scope of financial accounting here? So simply, whatever the definition is there, in the definition it will be gives the total information of that particular process of the accounting here. So here the first thing, or what are the first function, is systematic record of all the business transactions here, or they are called as recording here. So that means whatever the things we are to measure in terms of money, that the money related things are the economic transactions, that we have to enter in a systematic manner, that is the first function of the accounting here. So simply, we are identifying the economic related transactions, that we are identified here, and after that we are entered in a particular book here. So the book name is called as journal. The book name is called as journal. So first we are entered in the book of journal. So that is the recording section. And after we are entered into the journal of all the business transactions, the next function is called as, or next step is called as classifying. So here, every day we have done a number of transactions that will be related to the money, or that we have measured in terms of money. That transactions we have entered in daily basis. So that means every day we are maintaining the journal here. So here, number of transactions, it will be append in that particular transaction, a particular business in every day. So here, by using of the journal, we are not finding exact results of the particular account here. For that purpose, whatever the general transactions or what are the general entries are there, that we have to classify into the next category, that we have called as ledgers. So simply, a ledger is an account in this a particular related transactions we have entered in a particular book here. So each and every transactions we have maintained or we have opened a separate account in that the particular or the related transactions only we have to enter the book. The book name is called as ledger. So first we have entered in the books of journal, and after that it is classified into the ledgers. And at end of the particular period or at end of the month, we are finding of these ledger balances here. Either it is balance of credit or debit, that we have to find out here. So after ledger, after classifying, we go for the next thing, that is called as summarizing here. The summarizing means whatever the end balances of these ledgers will be there. So what are the end results of this ledger account? That again we are summarizing it in a particular statement. That statement is called as trial balance. So at a particular period of time, we are preparing a statement. That statement is called as trial balance. In this, all the end results of this ledger's account balances we have to post it here. We have entered here. The book name is called as trial balance. Okay, here all the end balances of the ledger, that we have to enter here. And after completion of this trial balance, we go for the next step, that is called as analyzing. So by the using of this trial balance, we are finding the results of either we are getting a profit or loss, or what is the balance sheet of the particular account, a particular business. Either they are having of assets, either they are having of liabilities. How many assets are there, how many liabilities are there, that we have to analyze, that we have to find out here. And after the finding of the profit and loss, or the balance sheet, or the position of the financial position of the company, that we have to interpret the results to the particular required parties. So we are based on these results, and we are interpret that either we are getting of losses, either we are getting of profits. Okay, and what is the financial position of the company, that we have to find out here. These are the information we are communicated to the interested parties or the required parties here. So this is called as functions of accounting here. In the same way, accounting cycle like this only here. So what is the accounting cycle? This, see here. So here, what is the accounting cycle means? Here, the cyclical process of from the starting to the end of the communicate to the information to the required parties. The cycle is called as a repeated process here. So whenever we consider the cycle of this accounting here means, you see here, this is called as cycle of the accounting here. So simply, first we go for the entering and after that, we are finding the results at end here. So this is the cyclical process. Every year it will be having a repeated process here. So that is called as accounting cycle here. So here we consider the accounting cycle. First we take the inputs. What are the inputs means? We are identify the transactions. That means it is related to the economic nature. Whatever the transactions that we have to measure in terms of money, that transactions we have to identify first. Whatever the things we are not measured in terms of money, the transactions that we are not enter the books of account. So first, whatever the money related things or whatever the things or what are the transactions, it measured in terms of money, the transactions we have identified here. Okay, and based on that, after identifying the transactions, in accounting cycle, the first step is called as recording of these transactions. Whatever the economic transactions or the business transactions are there, or what transactions is measured in terms of money, the transactions first we have to record in a book here. The book is called as general, or we are called as book of original entry. So that means every day how many transactions are there, the transactions we are entered in a systematic manner. The book name is called as general here. In this book we are entered all the transactions in a systematic manner or daily basis here. And after recording of these things, then we go for the next one, that is called as posting to the ledgers. After certain period of time, whatever the general entries are there or what we had entered the generals, that we have classified into the different categories. So the book is called as ledger. In the ledger we have posted all the general things here. So each and every entry we have opened a separate account, and the separate things, that means the related transactions of that particular account, we have posted in this ledger here. And after some particular period of time, we are finding the results of the end results of that particular account here. Either it is a credit balance or debit balances that we have find out here. And based on some particular period, or after the 6 months or 1 year, we have prepared a statement. The statement is called as trial balance. In this trial balance, whatever the ledger balances are there, that we have to summarize in a particular place here. Either it is a debit balance or the credit balances, that we have to find out and that we have to enter into this trial balance. And based on this trial balance, we have prepared a final accounts here. In the final accounts, it will be having up 3 steps. The first one is trading account, and the next one is profit and loss account, and the last one is balance sheet. It is a balance sheet, it is a statement, not a account here. So simply, first thing or first step, that is called as trading account, and second one is profit and loss account, and third one is balance sheet. In the preparation of the final accounts, these are the things will be there. So what is the trading account means? For the up to the manufacturing of any product, what are the expenses are there, what are the incomes are there, that we have to enter into the book. The book is the account is called as trading account here. By using of this trading account, either we are getting of gross profit or gross loss. How much gross loss will be there or gross profit is there, that we have to find out by using of this trading account. And after that, based on the trading account, we have prepared the next account, that is called as profit and loss account. In this profit and loss account, we have entered all the indirect expenses and all the indirect incomes here. Whatever the things remaining after entering into the trading account, what are the expenses are there, what are the incomes are there, that we have entered a book, that book is called as profit and loss account here. After manufacturing of the product, up to the reach to the product to the consumer, whatever the expenses or incomes are there, that we have to enter this book here. By using up this book, we are getting up either the net profit or net loss. Either we are getting up net profit or net loss. And After the preparation of the profit and loss account, based on the balances, what we are getting of net profit or net loss, we have prepared a statement that is called as balance sheet. So in the balance sheet, whatever the assets are there, what are the liabilities are there, that we have to enter here. What, how many assets we are having, how many the liabilities we are having, that we have to enter in this balance sheet. And based on that, we say that what is the financial position of the company. Either we are getting of assets more, either we are having of assets more, either we are having of liabilities are more, that we have to find out by using of this balance sheet. And based on these things, whatever the output we are getting, either you are getting of losses or the profits, either you are getting of what are the financial position of the company, what you are getting here, that the information or the results we are communicated to the required parties. See here, whatever the results you are getting, for example, if you are getting 1 lakh rupees of the profit here, or what are the financial position of the assets and liabilities, whatever the information you are getting, what are the results you are getting, that we are communicated to the required parties. So who are the required parties means, here we having of internal users are there, external users are there. So who required this information means, internal users are there, external users are there. Who are the internal users means, we see the first one is board of directors. So here the board of directors, they run the business here. So at that purpose, how much the profit they are getting, what is the financial position of the company, either they are having of losses or profits, or how many assets are there, liabilities are there, they must be known. Based on the profit and losses, based on the results of the company, results of the particular business, they are taking the actions, they are taking the decisions, so for the future period of time. So that's why these people, they require the accounting information. And the next one is partners. If it is a partnership firm, how much the profits they are getting, what are the assets are there, how much losses we are getting, they must be known the financial position of the company. So that's why these are the people also, they require the accounting information. And the managers, who are the managers, they run the business here. So they also require this information of the particular results, either they are getting profit or losses, or what the results we are getting here, that we have to know by these people here. And who are the officers, that are related to the particular business, they know the results of the particular accounting information here. So these are the internal people, that means within the company, these are the people is required the information of that particular accounting information. And after that we go for the external users, that means out of the company, who require this information means, here investors. The investors means who are invested money into the business, they are called as investors. These are the investors are known about the profit and losses of the company, how much the return they are getting here. So they are excited to know about the results of the particular thing here. So that's why these people also require the accounting information. And the next one is lenders. The lenders means who gave money to the company or the business is called as lenders. So they must will be known how much the money they are getting, what are the profits they are getting, either they are having a position to pay the interest or not, either they are return back of the money or not, they must will be known here. So that's why these people are also required here, required the information here. And the next one is suppliers, who supply the goods to the business, they also known about that particular results of the company. And the government agencies, for the government, for the applying of the taxes or the giving of subsidies, they know the information of this accounting here. And the customers, so who are using of that particular product, they also, the people of the customers or consumers also know about the particular results here. So these are the accounting internal and external results will be required people here. So thank you everyone.